Hello, I'm Rebecca Haddad, and I would like to thank the ICS Scientific Committee for giving me the opportunity to present the results from this work, which is a part of my PhD thesis in Ghent University in Belgium. I have nothing to disclose. Sleep disturbances are common in older adults living in nursing homes, and these disturbances are more severe in these patients than in community dwelling older people. And sleep impairment is associated with adverse outcomes in older adults, like cognitive dysfunction, physical decline, increased fall risk, poor quality of life, etc. Beyond the already known factors affecting sleep quality, nocturia is important to consider because nocturia is frequent in older adults, and both sleep and nocturia frequently coexist among older adults residing in nursing home. But taken together, the direct relationship between both sleep quality and nocturia among nursing homes residents has not been well established. So the objective of this study was to evaluate the association between self-reported sleep quality and nocturia in nursing home residents. A cross-sectional multicenter study approved by the local ethics committee was deployed in 2017 in two Belgian nursing homes. Residents aged over 65 years willing to participate in the validation study of the Dutch for Belgium Tongodi questionnaire were included, and the dependent variable was self-reported poor sleep quality using the Tongodi questionnaire with the answer, I would describe my sleep quality as bad. Independent variables included age, gender, nocturia defined by at least two nocturnal awakenings on the ICIQ, F or MLUTS, self-rated health status, insomnia symptoms, cognitive frailty score, antidepressant and hypnosedatives use. The association between nocturia and self-reported poor sleep quality was examined using three multivariable logistic regression analyses, and the potential confounding variables included in the multivariable analysis models were selected a priori using a directed acyclic graph based on literature data. 80 patients were included with a mean age of 89 years, 77% were women. As you can see, 28% had a self-reported poor sleep quality, and more than the half of the participants had nocturia. And nocturia was more frequent in patients with self-reported poor sleep quality versus without. Here are the results of multivariable analysis. In the model 1, nocturia was significantly associated with the poor sleep quality after adjusting for age and gender. This association was sustained when self-rated health status as a proxy of comorbidities and cognitive frailty score were included in this model. And in the final model, included the comorbidities and antidepressant and hypnosedative use, this association persisted too. In conclusion, a significant association between self-reported poor sleep quality and nocturia which persisted after controlling for potential confounders was found. The effect size was substantial, with a six-fold increased risk of self-reported poor sleep quality for nocturia, which was similar to the increase in risk found for self-rated health status. And it's of particular importance for clinical practice. Thank you.